Well, here we are at the Riversley fossil site, and this whole area is riddled with fossils. Everywhere I look, virtually every stone has some kind of fossilized animal in it, and they all relate back to a period of time 25 million years. So just randomly, I'm looking at this rock. Look closely here. There's one there. That's a fossilized bone. One up there. So it's not a bone. It's the silica or hard solution has entered the fossil and turned it into an actual rock. And just everywhere I point the camera, they're everywhere. What's on there? We don't know what that is, but it's certainly a bone. And virtually everywhere I put the camera, we're making our way up this little, what they call a jump up, and walking through the spinifex grass here. It's very sharp, this stuff. It's got some pretty sharp needles on it. And just those ones there, they can get you right through the genes. But there's a mysterious cave I saw from the roadside. I want to go and have a look at it. And it's that one there. I wonder. We're getting closer now. Here's the cave. Ooh, a little oasis from the heat. North facing, pretty good. I might get the agent to come down and give me a price. Wow, there we go. Ooh. Nice cool cave, quite roomy, and out here is the vast, oh, we've got a shade tree and the vast vista of the Gulf Country.
Nobody feels any pain tonight as I stand inside the rain. Everybody knows that baby's got new clothes, but lately I've been noticing her ribbons and her bows are falling from her curls. She takes just like a woman. Yes, she does.
Oh, this is the smallest library. Ah, want to take a photo? No. Oh, break the camera. Okay, I'll keep you out of it. How's it going?
Not bad.
Oh, good. You've got a good selection of stuff in there.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Lots of reading.
You've been... Yes, and that last lot there,
yeah,
isn't supposed to be in here because they're donated books that... Can be borrowed from people who aren't borrowers.
Yeah.
They can just take them.
They can just take them, yeah.
People like, who are travelling through.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. People like me. Yeah. We'll just take a look up there. But first, I've just found something down here. What is this thing? Let's get it into the light. Ah, yes. The old ring pull. Look at that. That's a museum piece now. They haven't been around since, well, the 70s, I'd say, early 80s. So that's a relic which we'll put back in the ground. Let's go up here. Up the steps. Into the lockup. What's in here, I wonder? Swing the door open. Well, once you leave the outside areas of Ada Vale and you come inside, it gets very dark, especially in the police lockup cell. Let's just see some of the stories in here. We've scanned around. There we go, they're on the wall. But this one particularly caught my interest. The Armed Madman. So what does it say about him? The Armed Madman, Jack Luby, who has been terrorising settlers in Ada Vale, has been captured. Well, I'm glad about that. Is that the man down here? We don't know. It could be him. Maybe not. The Ada Vale police history. What have we got here? Gee. It's a fairly comprehensive history. Crikey. For a little town, there's a lot of police records. Prints and mussel shell. It's deep. I cannot stand at this point. No, just got it. Well, hello. This is the Thompson River. The Thompson River joins the Barku River over there to form a creek, Cooper Creek. Two creeks forming a river. Hundreds of miles down there. This is the result of the summer storms. This water is still moving down. It feels quite fresh, it's not too muddy. It's cool, but it's very refreshing. I'm gonna follow the river down and see where it goes to. See you later.
Clouds so swift, rain won't lift, gate won't close, railings froze. Get your mind off winter time.
Wiry natives from the rugged mountainside, an horse was never saddled at the G-Bug.